Popcorn save you, boy. I'm going to put my car. Wszystkie mi budzi.
Mawlan!
Boy, suppose dance a boy? Or suppose dance a boy? Eh? Or suppose dance a boy?
Yeah?
That way you do, boy.
But all the it's memories like it's supposed to be so hard to hold ya. It's real hard, you
know. Yeah,
watch out. You know,
like,
come back to us.
I'm like, for that time, nobody. You don't care for anybody. You don't care for anybody.
Colin! You look when you come back home, you lie. You look when you come back home. You can't do that, boy. Can't do that, boy. Let alone what you have to ask, just go. Take away our money. You come back and I'm not sure. But you're a star, right? What do I do? Yes, bang, bang, boy. Tell me your friend, why spin the boat, boy? Not bad, my mother. Even my soul, like, nice time together. Life, I always become every soul. We be forgetting by me, no soul, yeah. Right?
I'm going to come back to you.
Thank you.
Oh. Family and friends, good evening. I take this opportunity to greet us in the wonderful name of Christ our Savior and soon coming King. We are here this evening as we pay tribute to the remains of our beloved brother this evening, Brother Victor, who had been tabernacling as we are, but my friends, he has reached the climax of his day. In other words, he has reached his journey end. And so too this evening, all of us someday will reach our journey's end. In spite of how healthy we are, in spite of how much money we have, in spite of how handsome or how looking we are this evening, one day we all are going to reach the climax of our day. So as we are here this evening to say goodbye to him, it's a wonderful opportunity for us in itself, for us to think about our own selves. If that was my case, I'll stand my case with God this evening. However, this evening, our dearly beloved brother Victor had lived his life. He lived his life to the best of his ability. He lived his life according to the choice that he had made. And so he has gone on this evening. On behalf of my family and others, we wish to extend our sincere condolences. And we pray that God will continue to comfort, God will continue to encourage, God will continue to uphold with his omnipotent right hand and grant peace to those, my friends, who mourn the parting or the loss of this brother this evening. And we trust this evening that as we continue to blend our hearts and our voices, that we all would be encouraged this evening and peradventure at the end of this service. Maybe somebody would say, I have decided to follow Jesus. Amen. Are you hearing me this evening? Maybe at the end of it, somebody would make a decision in their life to say, as the poet says, take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to thee. And if we really love and had cherished Victor this evening, then at his parting this evening, it should do something great in our life. It should bring us face to face with reality and help us, my friends, to prepare ourselves for that great and coming day. God bless us. We welcome the ministers of the gospel with us, Reverend Bramble, Reverend Taylor, and all who are assembled this evening, and we want to continue in the name of Jesus. Join with me this evening as we worship from that beautiful hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. What a friend we have in Jesus. bless in our hearts, Lord. Father and God, we come before you this evening in the name of your Son, Jesus. We know, Lord, it is in you we live, we move, and we have all our being. We thank thee today for the gift of life. We thank thee even now for another privilege that we could come, Lord, to call upon your holy and your righteous name. We know, gracious God, that you sit high and you look low and you look even into the hearts of men. And Lord, we know that your presence is here, there, and everywhere. And Lord, we appreciate your presence this day, even with us in the midst of this service. And Lord, you said in your word, in everything, we are to give you thanks. We give you thanks for the life of our beloved Victor this evening. We thank you, O God, for the years that you would have had him to serve in this world. We thank you, God, for the family in which you had placed him in. We thank you, God, for the many persons that were privileged to interact with him and the many lives, oh great God, that he has left a great impact even upon. And now, Lord, as he is deceased this evening, Lord, you have called him home for final settlement with you. Father, we release him into your hands and we tell you, thanks, great God, for the years that you have lent him. And this evening, as we release him to you, we know, God, that you are able to do for him that which his family could not have done. But great God, we pray for his family even now in a special way. We pray, dear God, in the name of Jesus, that God, you will stand even in the gap for them this evening. We pray, great God, that you will comfort them now as you comforted Mary and Martha, and give them, Lord, that sense of hope to know, oh great God, that you are ever faithful and you are ever sure. And Lord, you have promised to be with them even to the end. So we pray even now, great God, that make your arms available, that great God, they can lean on your everlasting arms. Grant them, oh God, your peace this evening, that your peace that passeth all understanding. Father God, we pray that even in the time of death, you will minister to them, oh God, that truly, Lord, they will come, oh great God, to reality, to know a charge to keep they have, a God to glorify, and a never dying soul to save, and it must be fitted for the sky. We pray, oh God, for friends and other relatives, distant and near relatives this evening in a very special way. Father God, we know and we understand the pain they feel by the parting of the friend. But oh God, we pray in the name of Jesus that God, you will touch them and you will touch them individually. And great God, you will touch them collectively. And Lord, when you touch them, God, you will speak peace and comfort even in their lives this evening. Cover them, Lord. Uphold them with your omnipotent right hand, great God. And continue, God, to be with them by day and by night. And great God, when they feel as though they cannot carry on, great God, we pray that, Lord, you will just stand in the gap, Lord. You will lift them up, Lord, and cause them to be able to stand. Father, we thank you today to be in this service. And we pray, oh God, that you will take over the service today. And we pray that, oh God, all that is to be done and said, Lord, will truly be to your honor and to your glory. We pray that even, great God, in the reading and the proclamation of your word, that, Lord, some word will touch our hearts, that even at the end of it, Lord, will be closer drawn to you. And peradventure, those who don't know you will come to know you as a personal indwelling Savior. Lord, abide with us now and continue, oh God, to have your own sweet way. And grant this evening, oh God, we pray that even the words of our mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, oh Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread.
And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
We continue as we share the first scripture reading from Psalm 23. And the person that would be doing the eulogy will stand by to share with us right after the psalm. Amen?
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He led me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Bless me, Lord. Hallelujah.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
This evening, we'll be celebrating the life of Robert Victor Jules, also known as Bless, Robbie, Tallman, and Dang Dang. Bless was born September 1st, 1977, at the San Fernando General Hospital to his mother, Ina Teasdale, and father, Alfred Jules, deceased. He was raised in a single-parent household. Bless grew up in Chachatres, Maruga, where he attended Bastia RC Primary School. Bless' family recalls a lot of fun memory growing up in Maruga, such as catching birds, hunting, swimming in the river, and lots more. Bless was the third of his mother's children, the ninth of his father's children, and the youngest of 11 siblings. Robbie worked as a skilled mason, was proud to be self-taught. His employers and laborers would often boast of how he could throw up a wall. Robbie left his handiwork all over Trinidad and Tobago. In the time of his passing, he lived in Maruga to Tobago, Chaguanas, Madingo, Point Fortin, and then back to Madingo, Teasdale Trace, where he settled and made his home. He came in as a stranger, but soon became a bona fide family member. Robbie was the life of the party. By the time 5-6 o'clock, Robbie was the first man in front of the parlor, where he would routinely call Miss Willow and buy the nip of punching, and then well, the line start. Bless was known to be quite a shy and reserved person until he take a drink, and he would be the loudest and the music entertainment artist, because he would start up his music box and his whole day Bless singing. One of his favorite songs was Buried Alive by Buju Banton. Bless was a part of the Parlor Boys, loved by them, members of the community, friends and family. He would go hunting with the Parlor Boys. They would cook, they would sell, cook, and make lime, and they would all have fun. Robbie lived a good life. He was known to be a kind and giving person. Without Robbie, the Parlor Boys and the lime would never be the same. He will always be missed. Robbie went liming with some of his friends by Anastasia, also known as Shiny, and came home around 7 that night and went to bed. Woke up at 5 Sunday morning, ponging on his mother's door and complaining of not feeling well. Went on the back step, where he remembered to call out to God in all his pain, then went back to bed. Being the good friend that he is, his friends came looking for him and found him unresponsive. They called the ambulance and they took him to the hospital. He had the surgery that same night and it was a success. Being as blessed as he is, he came out of ICU within 2 days and was doing very well for someone who had a blood vessel severed. Bless later took a turn for the worse and had a stroke on Tuesday and died on Thursday, 22nd July 2021 at the San Fernando General Hospital, leaving to mourn his mother, siblings, relatives, good friends who loved him dearly. Bless's death came as a shock to everyone. And I hope that we learned to appreciate life and everything in it, because tomorrow is not promised to no one. As I leave, I would like to sing his favorite song to you, Uncle Robbie. I was buried alive, but I'm still breathing. I don't know what tomorrow may bring, but I got a feeling I am alive. There must be a reason I was given one more chance. My heart still beating. I was buried alive, but I'm still breathing. I don't know what tomorrow may bring, but I got a feeling. Oh Lord, I am alive, so there must be a reason. I was given one more chance. My heart's still beating.
Amen. We thank you very much today. Let's continue to go forward.
When I die, I live on him.
Privilege to share with us from the word of the Lord this evening. May God use him all to his honor and to his glory. I appreciate it.
51. All right, good afternoon, everybody. It's my privilege to share part of the word this afternoon with you. I will be sharing with Reverend Alan Taylor. So I'm just going to turn to a portion of scripture and I'll ask us just to listen as we read it in your hearing. Portion of scripture is 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and we're reading from verse 51. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkle of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast and unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Amen. 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 And amen. O Danda. O Danda. Wing, 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 wing. Some of you wonder how come I know that. Dang Dang spent the last month working by me. And one of the things, you know, I listened when you all said somebody read in the young lady read in eulogy, Dang Dang could put up a wall. Man could really put up a wall. Built a whole room. And the thing with Dang Dang is that he was a real peaceful, quiet fellow. Never harassed nobody. But he used to keep you entertained. Dang Dang will stay with you and he will just talk and reminisce. And he'll remind you of so many different things. He gave me a riddle once that I spent a whole long time trying to solve. 1 to 9, 99,909. Solve that. He gave me another riddle. He said, Pastor Bramble, what is the shortest street in Princeton? I don't know if you all know it. I give you another chance. But Dang Dang is dead. And the Bible tells us that death is something that a lot of people fear. Why do we fear death? We fear death because death is unknown. We fear death because we don't know how we will die, when we will die, and what will be involved in death. And I've never seen anybody come back from the dead to tell anybody how death was. I heard a lot of people testify and write books. But I want to tell you something. None of them really explained to me what death is. There was this man who died. He was afraid of death too. They said his heart stopped in a restaurant. And when the heart stopped, he was so frightened, he lied on the ground. And this nurse came. And she knew CPR. And she spent a few minutes and she resurrected him. You know, when that man got up, he said, I will never fear death again. You know why? It was so peaceful. I want to tell you something. All of us will die. Death is something we can't fear because it will come. I want to use something from Dang Dang's train. Death is a great equalizer. The thing is, you will die, I will die. The rich will die, the poor will die. This COVID has shown me, you have money, you'll still die. You don't have money, you'll still die. You are East Indian, you will die. You are Negro, you will die. Whatever your color, you're bound to die someday. The Bible says, it's appointed unto man once to die. Not only that, but death is a great leveler. Because, you know, you take a level and put it to check to see something straight. Let me tell you something about death. You know, all of us going in the same grave. Nobody going 9 feet down, you know. We all going 6 foot. And if some of us want to burn, you're burning the same way. In the same crematorium. None of us going to have a different kind of death from anybody else. So whether you, whoever you are, you feel you're big or you feel you're small, we all going to end up dying. But I want to tell you some things that will make you not fear death. Death is just the beginning. Some of you in this area, you plant. Do you know when you put a seed down in the ground? If that seed does not die, no plant will come. The seed has to die because there's life in death. Once that seed dies, the new plant begins to grow. I want to put it to you this evening, if you don't know, having died, you're going to live again. The Bible tells us this mortality must put on immortality. Dang Dang is no longer here. His body is here. But Dang Dang has already put on immortality. Let me tell you why. Because when you die to when God comes back, we don't know how long it will be. But for you, while you're dead, you will never know. Time stops. So it comes like something immediately happened right after when you wake up again. All of us will die to live again. The problem is where you will end up living. Whether you live with Christ or you live in hell. The next thing is, death, the Bible says, is appointed to every man. I tell people, when you go in the grocery, and most of you ladies here, you know, you pick up things based on expiration date. And I know a lot of you run to Passage. I do. And Passage just have 5 for 20. But the problem with the 5 for 20 is expiring just now. So you have to use it quick. Can I put it to you that every single one of us here this afternoon has an expiration date? It's written somewhere on your body. A young pastor and I were chatting. He said, maybe behind your head. He said, but you can't see it. And nobody else can see it, but the angels can. The Bible says it's appointed unto man once to die. Your appointment has already been written. Not only that, but the third thing I want to tell you is this. Death going to mean a coming back together, a meeting with others who you would have left. You see Dang Dang died, but I want to tell his mother something. You're going to see him again. You're bound to see him again. You will see him again in glory. And all of you are somebody who would have died. Yes. You're going to see them again. You're going to see them in glory. Yes. So have that hope within you and stop fearing death. Because death is just another door that you're going to open. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Amen. Amen.
give to me.
We thank God greatly for that word that we received through Reverend Bramble today. And we continue, my friends, to face up with something that we have no real authority or power over.
Amen.
And let me just take 1 minute to add to what has been said by Reverend Bramble. And I want to talk that 1 minute about things that we cannot change.
Amen.
Things that we cannot change. Hey, my friends, we can born and grow up in Madingo Road.
Yeah.
But after we become educated or we get through certain things in life, somehow we feel that we can change, my friends, the residence in which we live. And so we could move on or we could migrate from here and we could go to Venezuela, we could go to the United States, we can go to Canada. There are things, my friends, that we have the control over in this world that we can change. There is that plaque I saw in many homes. God grant me the serenity to accept the things that I cannot change, courage to change the things that I can, and wisdom to know the difference. The difference there then is the difference between the things that I can change and the things that I cannot change. Quickly, my friends, three things, my friends. One is we cannot change life.
Man.
There will always be life. Because God made man and God blew into man's nostril the breath of life and man became a living soul. God made a covenant with Noah. But Lord, we understand that Jesus Christ said in John's Gospel chapter 10, I am come that you may have life and that you may have it more abundantly.
Man.
Find me not naive this evening with the statement I'm going to make. A young lady, my friends, and probably a young boy going around. And they're just enjoying themselves together. But they haven't planned, my friends, extension for the family. And somehow that young lady becomes pregnant, my friend. And she realizes there and then, I can't live in my mother's house again because I disrespect my mother's house. Are you hearing me this evening?
Amen.
Or probably my family might be a religious one in the which I think, and I cannot face with it, so I will do something to get rid of it. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
But that is not my brothers and my sisters bringing the end to life. We cannot, my friends, change life. There will always, my friends, be life. If there is not life in Madingo Road, there is life in Komoto.
Amen.
If there is not life in Komoto, there is life in Chacha Trace, Edward Trace, wherever. There will always, my friends, be life. We cannot change life. But secondly, quickly, my friends, we cannot change that either. Reverend Bramble actually, my friend, kind of pressed it into us when he says to us in the book of Hebrews 9:27, as it is appointed unto man once to die. You and I would recall pre-adventure from the beginning of creation. It was never God's plan that man should die. But because men thwarted the plan of God, because of men's errors of ways, because men has missed the mark, or we put it in a nice way as Paul put it, for the wages of sin is death. And we were saying this evening, in spite of how healthy we are, one day we are going to die. In spite of how much money we have, we are going to die. In spite, my friend, of how popular we are in the world, we are going to die. We may ask ourselves as I close this evening, where is Sir Ellis Clark, the first president of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago? He has died.
Amen.
Where is George Chambers? He has died. Where is Patrick Manning? He has died. Where are some of the great people around us? They all, my friends, have died. So just as we cannot change life, my dear friend, we cannot change death. Sooner or later, my friends, sooner or later, we all someday, hallelujah, would die. If we could have changed death, then the family could have made some kind of arrangement that this dearly beloved brother, this talented young man, this man that was so inspirational, this man that had captured, my friend, hallelujah, the friendship of so many. As I look around, I see us this evening, all in red. It speaks about oneness. It speaks about love. It speaks about fellowship. But with all that, my friend, the fellowship would be broken by the means of death. And dearly beloved, this evening, this young man is not here. And if death was a thing that we could have changed, my friend, then none of us would have been here at this service this evening. Not even the Son of God had escaped death, my dearly beloved, this evening. Oh, but we remember this evening, my friend, that we cannot change life. We cannot change death. But in my conclusion, my my friends, what we can do is to change the way we live. Are you hearing me this evening? We cannot change. There are things that we can then change around us. If you're living and you have a quarrelsome neighbor around you, my friend, you could change residence. Are you hearing me? A story was told, and here this week, then I will conclude. A story was told of these two persons that were living side by side in the community. And oh boy, there was row, row, row. And you know what happened? One of the ladies went by Obia Man. And she told the Obia Man all that was going on. Yeah. The Obia Man told her, you need to go home. And when you go home, as you get up in the morning and you're about to come outside to do your chores, fill your mouth with water. And don't spit it out until you get back inside the house. And do that for a couple of days and come back. Couple of days went by. And there was peace. There was quietness in the village. In the neighborhood. She went back by the Obia Man. The Obia Man said, how things went? She said, oh God, it went very good. Tell her, keep it that way. Are you hearing me this evening? She mouth was hot, thank you. Alright, so in conclusion, my friend, we cannot change life. We cannot change death. But what you and I can do is to change the way we live. We all are going to die someday. And death has no age limit with it. As a matter of fact, we would know about stillborn. We know about those who came into the world and they tallied for 2 weeks, 1 month, 1 year, as the case may be. As well as we'd have those who go, plus my friend, a century. But one day we are going to die. Would the death of Victor this evening bring about any change in the way you and I live? What I was glad about in the eulogy, about all the many things that were said, at that moment, when he felt that pain or whatever he was going through, he called on no other name but Jesus. Yes. And hear what the apostle says, neither is there salvation in any other, for there is no other name under heaven given among men whereby man should be saved. But at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. God bless you all this evening. God comfort and give you that sense of hope to move on with your lives. But know for certain, one day we all are going to be in the said position that Victor is in. He is saying to us, as I am, so you shall be. And as you all are, that's the way I was. God bless you this evening and grant you his peace. Let's worship again from the other hymn in our program. When peace like a river.
When peace like a river attended my way, when sorrows I see they were through, whatever my Lord thou hast taught me to say, it is well, it is well. Oh, rest in Lord.
Victor is saying to his mom this evening and other siblings, well, yeah, you will share a tear. That's normal. We are human beings. We'll express ourselves in that way and in other ways. But probably he's saying to you this evening, don't worry. Don't fret yourself too much. It is well with my soul. You see, I take liberty to say that because it is not where we begin the journey, but it's where the journey ends. And at the final part of his life, whatever his relation would have been with God earlier, my friend, as he came to the climax of his day, he cried out to God earnestly. And God, in his word, said, if we truly repent, he's faithful and just to forgive and will cleanse us from all unrighteousness. But here my final statement before Pastor Taylor close us in prayer this evening. Many of our beautiful young ladies around here may not be privileged to go up to represent Trinidad and Tobago in some beauty pageant. Are you hearing me? Some of our young men that are very good in football may never reach TNT team to go somewhere about. Are you hearing me? Some of our senior persons may not be qualified to go in some cookout competition. But you know what happened? All of us are privileged that we can make our peace calling and our election sure with God. God bless you, Pastor Taylor. Close us in prayer.
You know, our wise God. Father, we look to you at this very hour.
Yes,
we stretch our hands to you. Not a help, we know at this very hour.
Yes, Lord.
Father, as we come before you, we ask you at this hour, you know why we gather here at this point. Father, we ask for your blessing and peace upon the very family at this time.
Lord, yes, Lord.
Upon all family and friends at this time, oh God. Comfort them as you comfort Mary and Martha. Give them that strength to continue on this journey, oh God. Because someone is missing in the family at this time, oh God. But you send your son into the world that we might have a life and have it more abundantly.
Yes,
and the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob. Father, we lift now before you once again. Continue, God, to bless his mother. Continue, God, to grant her that strength and that peace, oh God.
Yes,
Father, we just ask for your blessing upon everyone at this time.
Yes,
continue, God, to bless us and keep
yeah,
us.
Lord.
In Jesus' name, I ask all these things. Amen.
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 The grace of Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God and the precious of Holy Spirit, rest in the soul, not forevermore. Amen. Dearly beloved, as we prepare ourselves to go to the place of internment, I believe those who would want to pay, as you probably all may not be going across to the burial ground. And when you go there, probably it may not be in a convenient place that you'd want to view. So while we sing this hymn, you are free to come and take your view as we prepare ourselves to take our exit.
There's a land that is fairer than there. And I think we can see.
Sing an hallelujah, we shall have a grand time. Keep on Somebody hold this and yeah, you read.
Some for the man.
You take it over there, so you're stopping for the pala. You put money for the pala already.
Rasta! Rasta!
Rasta!
Rasta!
Rasta!
Rasta!
Don't want to stick for the food.
Rasta, boy. Rasta, that way, do we rest? Pala, boys. Pala, boys, for life, boy, brother, boy.
Where you might be thinking, boy? Rest him down right there. Rest him right
there. Go up again. Rest him down right there. Rest him down.
Where you might coming down.
No, where the man? Where the
man? Yes, sir.
Let's sit down right there.
No, where the man?
You don't put him back inside the tent.
No, where the man?
Put the bench somewhere. Let's put the bench somewhere.
Put the bench up. Let the man sit down. Let's sit down. Put the bench.
Oh, where the man? No, man.
Put the bench somewhere. You don't like this.
Not committing.
No, I'm doing it. Get down!
Let's go. Get
up. Damn!
Don't ever pass your
street. Never, man.
Hey, hey.
Don't ever pass your street.
We meet again, my brother.
Don't ever
pass your street.
We will always keep it up for you, boy. Dang, dang! Rasta!
Dang, dang! As the sun rises here, we'll be sold, yeah. Here we'll just meet. I leave you right here, soldier. You tell nobody you're going by.
No, I'm going
to be hard, soldier, boy. It'll be hard, boy.
Yeah.
You can do that, boy.
Life, my brother. Life, boy. And the hard one out here still living, boy. Good one going, boy, brother, boy. Yeah, son. Young, strong man, boy. We going, boy. But yeah, life, my brother, boy. One day we go meet you, know, brother. One day we go meet, boy. We go talk, boy, brother, boy. We go talk, boy. Love you, boy. Love you, boy, brother, boy. You're home, boy, brother, boy. You're always home here, boy. No matter where you live. No matter where you live, boy, brother, boy. This is your tough, boy. In front of the Pala, boy. Pala boys, boy. You make this name, boy. You and Brent make that name, boy. Pala boys, you understand? And we call, we hold phone, boy. Anyway, boy, brother, boy. Dang, dang. Dang, dang. Rest in peace, my brother. Rest in peace, my brother. Fly high, Rasta. Rasta! 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 Fly high, my brother.
Dang, dang!
Fly high.
Never living.
Never faithful.
Never stop, brother. Rasta, the first.
Fuck, my brother. I'm going down the road. I'm going down the road. Dang, dang, man. Bless, man.
Get it till we come home, boy. And look how we had to wait for how you to come home, brother, boy.
It's a chance to fly.
Look how we had to wait for you to come home, brother.
Yeah.
Rasta. Rasta.
Happy, boy. Fuck, boy.
What is tune, boy? Well, I play that tune before we leave, boy. There we go.
Let's
play that tune before you leave. Jojo, you charge up, boy. You charge up, boy.
You play something, boy.
Let's play that before we leave, boy.
Boy, boy.
I'm gonna stand up here and sing that tune so hard. I'm gonna stop in the middle of the road and sing that tune, boy. Oh, bless, boy. Was looking for the comeback to soul, yeah. Hit my heart, soul, yeah. Hit my real hard, boy. Only the morning, I come to the live with now, soul, yeah. Welcome to the live with only the morning, soul, yeah. When nobody got a lot from bag, boy, but when my drink, it's cost, soul, yeah. But you're not supposed to be so hard, soul, brother, boy.
You must tell you, brother, boy.
It was gunshot. Yes. It was stabbing. There are repercussions. But Jahaya, boy. Jahaya back. The father higher back 100, brother. But if it was gunshot or anything,
You don't know, boy. You understand? But tell that, brother, boy.
What's
the father higher.
Boy.
We go hurting, no, brother.
I was very alive when I was here breathing. I don't know what to bring when I have to feed it.
Dang, dang.
Very alive.
Watch man. Let the horse man know that now.
Yeah, don't tell him already. I talked to you already.
No, they can't do that now.
Where that?
Walking up right out of the junction. Ride it. Junction, ride
it.
See if you got a look at it.
I'm not sorry.
come after.
I will report you.
Why is this thing, boy?
Because we must have one with the whole cave in. And a slip by.
Nah, don't worry, I bless. That's like the move.
I'll give you
If she wants to go back, she goes to the like that she wants to go back. Somebody help us, son, are we?
Come on, 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 come on
Hold it.
Hold it.
Thank you. I don't care about them. So I could go on YouTube later. I want to see. Man, I went and checked it. They are local.
Oh, it's all out, y'all. Friday and tomorrow.
Look for the mass.
I tell you, I have to finish.
Yeah, I tell you.